So far, we've reminded ourselves of the basics of linear programming by examining it in just two dimensions. Then we built up some vocabulary and notation that allows us to extend these notions to n dimensions. Now we're ready for the culmination of all this work in the fundamental theorem of linear programming, which captures the idea that optimal solutions should be at the corners, also called extreme points, of the feasible region. And it tells us that we need only consider basic feasible solutions.
Precisely, the theorem states that given a linear program in this standard form, where A is an m by n matrix of rank m, then if there's a feasible solution, there is a basic feasible solution. And if there is an optimal feasible solution, there is an optimal basic feasible solution. We'll start by proving the first point. Let x be a feasible solution, and we'll consider only the positive entries. Without loss of generality, let's assume that those are the first p. Then it must be the case that this linear combination of the columns a1 through ap is equal to b. That is, after all, part of what it means to be feasible. There are two cases. First, suppose that the columns a1 through ap are linearly independent. Then it's not possible that p should be greater than m. Recall that these vectors are only m elements long. If p is equal to m, well then x is basic already, and we're done. P could be less than m, that would mean that x is degenerate, but then we can just add columns to form a linearly independent basis, and we would be all right. So that then covers the case where these columns are linearly independent. Next, suppose that those columns are linearly dependent. Well, that means there are coefficients y1 through yp such that this linear combination of the columns is equal to 0 with at least one of the coefficients yi positive. Then we're going to choose this parameter epsilon in a very clever way so that it's the minimum of these ratios xi by yi among all these i's such that yi is positive. Then multiplying this equation by this epsilon and subtracting it from this one, we end up with this equation here. These coefficients must represent another feasible solution, but by our choice of epsilon, we've set at least one of these coefficients to 0, while the others have remained positive. So we've reduced the number of positive entries in x, and we can repeat this over and over until case 1 is reached, where a1 through ap are linearly independent. Now on to part 2 of the theorem. This will feel similar to the first part. We want to show that if there's an optimal feasible solution, there's an optimal basic feasible solution. We let x be an optimal feasible solution with non-zero entries x1 through xp. Well, it's feasible, so this linear combination of the columns of A, then, must be equal to B. And because it's optimal, its objective value, C transpose x, must be the maximum over all possible feasible x. Again, we first consider the case where the columns A1 through AP are linearly independent. And the situation is the same as before. P being greater than M is impossible, equal means that it's a basic solution, and less just means that it's a degenerate solution. This case is simple. If these columns are linearly dependent, then there exists a set of coefficients y1 through yp such that the linear combination of the columns is equal to 0 with at least one of the y's being positive. Note, however, for epsilon sufficiently close to 0 in both the positive and the negative direction, x minus epsilon y is still feasible. Multiply epsilon times this equation and add it to this equation, and we end up still with a set of coefficients equal to b. Thus, C transpose y has to be equal to 0. If it weren't, then C transpose x would be strictly less than C transpose times x minus epsilon y. We can choose the right sign on epsilon so that this inequality holds. But this is impossible because x is optimal. We conclude that C transpose y is equal to 0, and then we can choose epsilon to be the same thing we chose it before. It'll still give us an optimal feasible solution, only this little time it'll have smaller support because we're able to choose it to set one of the coefficients of this vector here to 0 that wasn't 0 before. And we can repeat playing this game over and over until we reach the case where a1 through ap are linearly independent.
We've just seen how the fundamental theorem of linear programming tells us that we can always achieve an optimal value for the program with a basic solution. Moreover, basic solutions come from the choice of m linearly independent columns for the basis. Remember this key point going forward.